Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. When it comes to AI-generated content, we often hear about text generation. There's also image generation, video generation, but we don't quite hear about audio generation. In today's video, I'm going to talk about a project which can take a video which originally do not have any audio. It will analyze the content of that video and generate an audio based on the visual happening in that audio. Okay, so it's a little bit different. Today I'm starting inside a video editor, and that is because I found it to be the easiest way to explain what is happening in this project. So on the right here, I have a video, and at the bottom here, you can see the audio waveform. So originally, this video did not have any audio. When I pass this video over to the project, by the way, it's called MM Audio, the model analyzed the content of that video and then generated some audio based on that content itself. So I'm going to play the video, and then these peaks here are where we actually hear something. Okay, so I hope you were able to hear that. Basically, we got noise when we are shooting from a phone camera or something. We have that background noise that was generated by the model. Plus, when the monkey was eating, so these spikes that we have here, those also were generated by that model. The good thing about this is that it actually synced the different sound effect based on the visual which is happening in that video. So as you can see here, we have the monkey starting to eat, and around here we get that sound from eating. In here, the monkey drop it, and we have another sound here, and we have another sound effect here as well. Moving forward, you can see that they start eating again, and again we got that sound effect. So this is a demo video from the project page itself. I'm going to play it, and it's about 30 seconds long. Okay, so I hope you were able to appreciate what was happening, and I'm going to go back to this video here and go forward a little bit. So right here, when we got an impact, that is when we got a sound effect, and then we got another sound effect again when the tool hit the ice. And then when we got the breaking part, again we got that same sound effect. So it's based on what is happening in the video. Now here's another one, and this clip is about the ocean, and you can see those waves coming up, and every time they are coming in, we have that sound effect happening. Now here's another one where we have something dropping in, I'm guessing liquid water maybe. And we again have that sound effect. We also have the atmosphere, the background effect as well, that was generated by the model. All right, so this one is a crowded area, people celebrating something. So everything was generated by the model here. The cheers, the crowd, the clapping of hands, everything was generated, and it was synced with the video. Now, I did not do anything. It was the AI that synced the audio and the video together. All right, so here's the project page. Like I said, it's called MM Audio, and you can take a look at the GitHub repository. We have some highlights here, and this one is the video I showed you. We have an installation process down below. You will need to install it manually, and the models are provided down below here. So this is going to be the standalone version. In today's video, I'm going to show you how to do this inside of ComfyUI. We have a ComfyUI custom nodes right here. It's by Kijai, and probably from previous video, you already know this awesome author. Now, this one, it says it's work in progress, but from my testing, I was able to generate that video for the monkey. I will also show you a couple of other examples I've done, and right now it is working. There is just one thing that you will need to know. Right now, this is a very early project. It started 2 days ago, as you can see from the GitHub commit here, and there is just one requirement. You will need to have Torch 2.5.1. That is the version which this project supports. So if you've downloaded your Comfy UI a while back, then you will need to download the latest version in order for this to work. Or you can probably take a risk and upgrade your Torch dependencies to 2.5.1. Now, in my case, I've just downloaded a new Comfy UI installation and I've installed this custom node over there. All right, so this is a new Comfy UI installation. And as you can see, I'm inside the output folder here. I've done a couple of generation to save on time, and I'm just going to show it to you. So the first one here is without any audio, and it's just the ocean. We don't have any audio in this one. And this one that says audio is the one that was generated. Okay, so this was about waves. Now this one came out a little bit different than what I was expecting. My prompt was a woman walking on beach. So I was expecting to hear the footsteps. It actually gave me something that would be like a documentary. We have a background music and somebody is narrating the video. All right, I don't think this is an actual language. It's pretty much gibberish, but you can see where it's going. All right, so this one is start above the water, and then these divers go inside the water. Now this one is a busy road, and it's just the vehicle noise that you will be hearing. All right, so this last one you've already seen, I've already showed it to you. It's the monkey. There's actually a part that I did not show to you. This is where it's eating. And hopefully you got that part where the camera is moving, and we actually got a sound effect for that as well. All right, so if you'd like to give it a try, again, like I said, you will need Comfy UI. You will need to be on Torch 2.5.1, and you can easily do it by downloading the latest Comfy UI version. Now, as of the day of recording, this custom node is not available inside the manager. So we'll need to install it manually. So let's go inside of Comfy UI. We'll go into the Comfy UI folder, custom nodes folder, and at the top here, type in CMD, press enter. This will open a command prompt. Now, as always, I will have a link in the description below to this GitHub repository. So you will just need to go and click on code, and then click here where it says copy, then type in git clone and paste the link, press enter. It will clone this GitHub repository. We'll need to install the requirements, and for once, in the README, they actually have a really good installation guide. We have the full path for the Comfy UI portable folder. So we can select this line here, press Ctrl C to copy. Then probably in your terminal, you will be inside the custom nodes folder. Type in CD dot dot, press enter. This will take you to the Comfy UI folder. Now we'll need to go back once more. So type in CD dot dot, and then we'll go back to this Comfy UI portable folder. Now in here, you can press Control V to paste. Some of you may have to do Control Shift and V in order to paste. But once you have this line here, press enter, and it will install the requirements. Now, if you install a new version of Comfy UI, you will also need to install Accelerate. For some reason, it's not included here, and I got the error that Accelerate module was not found. So if you get that same error, you can press up on your arrow keys and then erase the last part until we have pip install, and then you will type in Accelerate like this, press enter, and it will install it. Now for the next part, you will need to have this video helper suite custom node install, since this is what we will be using to upload a video. We'll also have one that is going to combine the video and save it for us. So in case you don't have it, you can go into the manager here, go inside custom nodes manager, and then at the top here, you can search for video suite. And The actual name is Video Helper Suite. So you can search it like this and install this one here. Now, once you install it, you will need to restart your Comfy UI and then come back to Comfy UI. Now, the workflow itself is already included in the custom node. So we'll go into workflow here, click on open, go inside your Comfy UI portable folder, Comfy UI, look for the custom nodes folder, go inside it. There should be a folder called Comfy UI MM Audio. Go inside it and there will be examples. Click on it and you will get one test.json file. Select it, click on open. It will open the workflow. If you do not see anything, click on this square icon here. It will reset the view and this is the workflow. So at the top here, these two nodes will need to download 4 models. So back to the GitHub repository, we'll go down. There will be a link that says save tensors available here and click on the link. It will take you to Hugging Face page where you can download the FP16 version or the FP32 version. Now for my test, I've used the FP16 version, but you can give the FP32 a try. You will need to download 4 models. So this one is the main checkpoint. You can think of it as if we are doing the load simple checkpoint. Now the bottom here, we have a VAE. We have a sync former model, and then we have a clip model. So the model file itself are these two here. So you can download any one of these. Make sure that if you download the FP32, then for the rest, you will download the FP32 version. Now the name should be fairly easy. We have the VAE here. We have this sync former here, and then we have the clip. Downloading it, simple, just click on this download button here. Once it's downloaded, it will be in your downloads folder most likely. So go into your downloads folder, highlight everything, press Ctrl X to cut, and then go inside of Comfy UI, go into the models folder, and in here you will need to create a new folder. So you can click on new folder and type in MM Audio like this. Now go inside it and then paste those files. So you should have all 4 files here like this. In even the model file, the main checkpoint should be here. Now this NVIDIA folder that you see here will be automatically created when you run the workflow. It will also download the necessary components. Okay, so back to the workflow, you can go into edit, click on refresh node. You can click on the dropdown and select the model here. Now, if you've downloaded the FP32 version, then make sure to change these two options to FP32. Now, next you will need to get a video in order to upload here. Now, for me, I'm on a 12 gigabyte VRAM card. And when I tried to upload a 1-minute video, I got an out of memory error. Now, it's probably because of the video resolution, or maybe it's because of the length. I'm not quite sure, but I was able to generate and get an audio file. 4 videos which were less than 1 minute long. So you can take this as a sort of benchmark. And if you have more VRAM, you can go for higher duration. If you have less VRAM, maybe go for less, at least for the first generation, just to test out if it's going to work. So to add a video here, go for this load video node, click on choose video to upload, and then select a video that you've downloaded previously. I'm going to select this monkey again. This is the one that I tested before. Now in here, in this audio sampler, this top part is the positive prompt. So you can type in something. I would say monkey eating noise maybe. And in this video combined here, we have an option here that says save output. You can toggle it on. If it is false, you will only get a preview. And when you close your Comfy UI, you start Comfy UI again, you will lose that video output. So changing it to on means that you are saving that output. Now, because I'm recording right now, I will not be able to generate. It actually takes 100% of GPU, for me at least. So I'm going to stop recording and then come back when it's completed. All right, so it's completed here. And if you've saved it, it should be inside your outputs directory here. By the way, in case you did not save it, it will be inside the Comfy UI folder and it will be inside temp here. These are where all the temporary files are stored. So you can go here, copy it, paste it somewhere else before you lose your output. This is the last one for me. And I think this one is without the audio. Yes, and this one will be with the audio. It feels like it's the same. I'm not sure, I have to compare it inside my video editor. Oh, I think it's because of the seed number. Oh yes, so when you load the workflow, the seed is fixed, and that's why I got the same result. Basically, if you want to have different results and you want to experiment and try to find that optimal audio, then you can change this to randomize. All right, so I think this is a great project. It came out at the right time as well. We know that we got Sora, which got released, and there's also the other one, the Hunyuan. I'm not sure if I'm pronouncing it right, but now you can generate a video there and you can generate the audio using this project. I think it says here in this GitHub repository, not this one, the main project one. Yes. Here it tells you that these videos were generated using the MovieGen. We have the Hunyuan, and then we have VGG Sound here, and there's one with Sora as well. The audio were all generated using this MM Audio algorithm. So you can take a look at the project. Let me know what you think about this. And we don't quite hear about audio generation, so I think this is a great project to get started with. Hopefully we see some improvements and maybe some more projects. All right, so thank you for watching until the very end. I hope you have a great day. Take care, and I will see you next time.